If you clean up data, this is a common problem. It's a product code, but I want to split it into different components. I've color coded it for simplicity. To do that, we have to use Power Query split by position. And then you put a comma delimited list. It'll split it. The problem is counting those positions is a pain. So let's see how to do it properly and accurately. Here is the raw data. This is a table. Name of the table is table one. I'm going to use Power Query. So close this file, open a blank new file, go to get data from file Excel and choose that file. Choose the table, click on transform. We have only one column. So right click on the column heading, say split column by positions. How does this work? Well, you have to understand the exact position numbers. It begins with zero. For example, if I just want the first character Q in a separate column, I still have to type zero because that's where it starts, and then comma one. Zero is the beginning, one is the ending. So one column containing just the Q, and then the rest of it goes into second column. Let's take another example. I want Q in a separate column and then that 4001 in separate column. 0 comma 1, we just saw that, and four more characters. So after comma, where is 4001 ending? At position number 5. So I write 5. Now it'll create three columns. One is just single character, then there are next four characters, and then the rest of it. So now if I really want to use it to split multiple columns, I have to know the exact column positions. The practical problem is identifying these exact positions. It's very confusing. We will make mistakes and then undo it and then repeat it, trial and error. So this is inefficient. I need to know the exact positions. And in order to know that, I'm going to put a little extra effort to prevent further mistakes. I click on one of the rows or cells actually. I'll see the value here. I'm going to pick up that value. Doesn't matter which row you pick up, copy it. Now I'm going to go to Home tab, enter data. Make sure my cursor is in the first cell and paste it. It'll still make it a header, but I say undo header. Done. Click OK. A new table we got with just one row. Now this one I want to split into individual characters. Right click on the column heading, split column, this time by number of characters. How many characters? Just one, but repeatedly. Very powerful feature, doesn't exist in Excel. Now it created 16 columns because there were 16 characters. I don't want to refer to them like this. I want them vertically. That's transpose. So go to the transform option or menu, click on transpose. Text will remain left aligned, numbers will go right aligned. I don't want that. So click on this data type button and make it text. So everyone is left aligned nicely. Already this is great so that I can pick and choose the correct position without confusion. But wait, I need that original thing for reference as well. So double click means rename the column and paste again. So that's your original value. Now it's perfect. Use the snip tool and take a screenshot of this. You want the column and the row numbers. Why are we taking a screenshot? Because I want to refer to it while I'm working on Power Query. I have pasted it in Paintbrush, but you can do it in any other tool. Keep this open. Come back to Power Query. Go to our original table. Split column by positions. And now I can specify positions confidently because I have a visual reference. So if I'm confused, I go back to my Paintbrush and say, OK, what do I want? Q. So that's number one. And then I want to end at 5. Then I want to end at 8. So 1, 5, 8. Great. And after that, I want these three, which is 11, or rather 12, and then 14. That's it. Job done. Now, one very important thing to understand. Power Query applies change type all the time. And many cases, it's not desirable. Case in point, look at this. We said four characters here. Looks okay. But here it suddenly became three characters. Why? Because it forced it to be a number column. So change type, not a good idea here. In fact, in general, don't trust what change type does. It is important to manually cross-check all the column types. Sometimes you are suspicious. For example, in row 6, this is FS, whereas all others seem to be 00. Now you want to cross-check. How do you do that? Look at the applied steps. We are at the last step right now. Just remember the row position 6. Click on the previous step and look at row 6. Yes, it is FS, so it is correct. Now before we finish, few things to be done. All these columns will have a name like .1, .2. You will need to double click and give them better names. I'm just going to do that quickly. Finally, this table is no longer required, so right click on it and delete it. Now you can go to close and load, ideally go to load 2 and choose the correct destination. This color coding is not automatic, of course. I have put it manually to explain this better. This will work exactly the same way in Power BI as well. So there you have it, a smarter and more accurate way of splitting columns by position. Try it out and let me know if you like it. Do you have a better way of doing this? Do let me know. And most importantly, share it with as many people as you can and give me ideas for more videos. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.